Coach, if you would, just an opening statement to start out about the game today.
Well, that's a tough pill to swallow. You know, we came into the game really believing we could win the football game. That's not any disrespect to Whitewater, but we thought we were good enough to beat them. And, you know, we didn't, obviously, often in the big picture, you just don't make enough plays, whether it's converting on third down or we gave up a couple deep balls early in the game, and that hurt. You know, we came back in the second half and hold them without any points. And you just look at the stats here, we outgained them by 80 yards or more plays than them. It's just hard. It's just hard to win. I'm really proud of our players and our coaches. And this is not an easy time right now, trust me. Our kids played hard, they competed, gave us everything they had. But I mean, they're four-time defending national champs, and I thought we could beat them. I really did. I really did, man. I thought we'd beat them, and we didn't. That's the way it is.
Go ahead and open up for questions.
Oh, Luke, did you feel like you were going to beat them too, like Coach just said?
Yeah, I mean, we came out and just drove right down that first possession. We had everything clicking, everything was going well, and, you know, just one of our coaches yesterday said five plays you can make this game, and you want to be on the good half of those five plays. And we were on the good half of some of those five plays in that first half. I felt like we had good control over it. And then, you know, we're on the wrong side of some of those plays. But that's football. And, you know, I don't think the score really said how the game was. And they're a heck of a football team, but so are we. So it's just a tough pill to swallow. It really was.
You guys racked up 475 yards. It's nothing to sneeze at. Some trouble getting into the end zone, though. What was the problem finishing?
We would get down there, and then the biggest thing we did was just shot ourselves in the foot. You know, we'd have a five-yard penalty. We'd have, you know, blown block. We'd have a blown, you know, they come up and press us different than we thought they would, and some of the plays just weren't coming out like we thought they would.
The field really shrinks down there, and they played it well when you get down there. But we had opportunities down there, no doubt. You know, they also had a few opportunities down there, too, and couldn't score. You know, the field, it just gets tough. You know, when you face a good team, it shrinks down there. But, you know, you just look at it. I was telling the players that, you know, everybody's going to go back and say, if this, you know, we got protection wrong. It cost us a third down play. You give up a deep ball, you give up a draw on third and 18, and didn't score on it, but it flipped the field, and, you know, and some of that stuff. And it's just a play here or there that it's really, it's just tough. It's just hard. It's hard because the football team, they beat us, okay? I understand it. They beat us, and I congratulate them, but it's a game we could have won.
Alex, it seemed pretty balanced between the run and the pass. How tough was it to stop them? What was the problem stopping them?
I think it first and foremost came down to just making tackles. I felt like we were in the right place a lot of the time, and we just didn't come through. As far as passing, it came down to a couple plays on the field. I mean, there was one where we jumped off sides and they just threw it up, and the kid made a good play on it. It's really tough. And so we talked about that all week. You know, there's going to be four or five balls that we have to win down the field. And when those opportunities came, we didn't really take advantage of that. And that put us in a tough position in the red zone, and, you know, we weren't able to hold. So, you know, they had a good game plan. We had a good game plan. Just came down a couple plays, and, you know, unfortunately, we didn't make them. So.
They've won a few national championships over the years. You think their experience or maybe just the reputation was a factor today?
For us, honestly, it didn't really matter. I mean, we knew what we were up against. We knew that they were going to be a really good football team. The experience thing didn't really matter. I mean, we knew that we had a really good football team and that we could compete with them on defense, offense, and special teams. So as far as experience, like, we weren't really concerned about that. Plus, they had a whole new coaching staff, and it's a different team, we thought. So, like, it doesn't really matter. We're just going to bring what we have out there, and we're going to compete for 60 minutes, and, you know, hopefully. hopefully we come out on top.
Our kids weren't in awe. And it's all respect. I'm not saying that because I don't respect Whitewater. But our kids were not in awe. Our kids really believed we could win this football game.
Coach, you guys came out and you were forcing a lot of turnovers. Just unfortunate to get
Tell me about it. They hit a ball on the ground three times and none of them bounced our way. Any one of those changes the game. We can sit here and whine about that forever. Bottom line is, you get more points than we did.
Coach, can I ask you or your seniors just kind of reflect on the ride, you know, where the program has, where the arc has been over the last 4 years, especially the last two getting to the playoffs again?
Well, the seniors, it's the best senior class ever in the history of Wheaton College when you add up the wins and losses, by far. It's the best senior class, man. They're really good. They won three conference titles. Won 22-2 here the last 2 years. And back-to-back conference titles, I mean, it's huge. You know, we had a heartbreaking loss last year in the second round. Missed the field goal to win the game. It's just hard to go out that way. It's just really, really hard to go out exit that way, you know. You want to exit with a win, winning the whole thing. And these guys were good enough. They really were, but they didn't. You know, I'm not saying that Whitewater, like I said, they're a good team. So are we.
Either of you guys, thoughts?
I mean, this is my fifth year. I was blessed to be able to come back from injury. And just like Coach just said, I mean, this is the best football team I've ever played on. And it wasn't like a ride like we, you know, like you just said, it wasn't, we expected to do that. There was no ride that we were getting on. It was, we had a goal that we set last year, came up short. This year we had the same goal, and we knew we could do it. Every single game we wanted to do it, knowing we can win the game. And the Whitewater came out, yeah, they have a lot of championships, but they got up just like we did this morning. They went to bed just like we did last night. They're not a super power team. They're a great football team, we are too, you know? And there's nothing, we didn't see it as a ride. We saw it as an honor and a blessing to be able to come out there and go 11-1 back-to-back years. Not a lot of teams do that. Not a lot of teams do that.
Yeah, I would back that up. I mean, it's been it's been a great opportunity to obviously play for this program and be able to wear Wheaton on Saturdays. And to have the success that we've had on the field has obviously, you know, made it that much better. Just to see guys who are selfless and who are willing to put the team before their own stats and their own accomplishments, like that stuff doesn't matter to us. And so it was really tough to obviously come up short today because we felt like we had a team that was a team that could really make a run and win it all this year from top to bottom. And so obviously today is not the easiest feeling in the world, but I'm definitely grateful for the opportunity to play here and to play the seniors and all the other guys on the team because I know that they gave their all. And to be the most winning senior class in history is obviously it's a great, you know, way to go out. So,
any other questions? Thanks, guys.
Great. Thanks,
guys. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.